stared at this one region for 54 nights.
This new research marks the first time that so many of these central stars have had their orbits determined so precisely. The data also reveals a lot about the characteristics of these stars and how they were formed. One of the stars that the astronomers were unique to follow it for a complete orbit. The star approached the central black hole to within just one light day. That's just five times the distance of the entry to the sun. Professor Reinhard Genzel from the Max Planck Institute for Extraterrestrial Physics in Germany was a little leader between that made the discovery. Reinhard, why is it so important to study the center of the Milky Way?
Well, you see, the Milky Way center is one of the most important laboratories we have to study in very great detail what's happening in the centers of galaxies, in much more detail than we could ever hope to do in all our galaxies. Yet, here we are, we can study where there's a central black hole that happens around the sun, but there are very general issues which we'd like to explore, which you cannot really study that much in detail in a very collective way.
Dr. Shepard, listen, this is the first author of the paper reporting the study. So Shepard, tell us, what's the most important result you obtained?
The most important result of our research was doing our good evidence for the existence of a massive black hole in the center of the Milky Way. The mass of this black hole is around 4 million masses, and you know the mass of the center of the Milky Way.
This is, of course, an amazing result, but the team doesn't plan to stop here. We're an artist that uses the vaulting beam of adaptive optics to remove the blurring effects of the atmosphere. In the future, we plan to do even better, to get higher resolution images by using another new technique called interferometry. This is where you combine the light from two or more of the TCU telescopes together. So why not? What's the next step?
See, at this point, we really are fully sure that there's a massive black hole in the center of our Milky Way. The next thing we want to actually play with it. Play with it in the sense that we want to use it as a tool to test the general relativity of the theory of Einstein is actually wrong, all right.
Wow, playing with black holes to test relativity. That's pretty cool stuff. I'm Dr. J, signing off for the ESOcast. Join me again next time for another cosmic adventure.
Surroundings were naturally are of the fact that the island had nothing to do with the observatory.
So clearly the crew couldn't do more
Observatory, which is celebrating its 40th anniversary and became the largest astronomical observatory of its time, leading Europe to the front line of astronomical research, is still one of the most scientifically productive in ground-based astronomy. This is the ESOcast, cutting-edge science and life behind the scenes of ESO, the European Southern Observatory, exploring the universe's ultimate frontier with our host, Dr. Joe, a.k.a. Dr. Joe Lisko.
In this episode, we're going to celebrate an anniversary. Quite an amazing one, too. One of the most successful ground-based astronomical observatories in the world, LaSEA, is turning 40.
With about 300 refereed publications arising from the observatory per year, LaSEA remains at the forefront of astronomy. LaSEA has led to an enormous number of scientific discoveries, including several firsts. The Hubb Spectrograph is the world's foremost extrasolar planet hunter. It detected the system around GLEASO 581, which contains what may be the first known rocky planet in a habitable zone outside the solar system. Several telescopes at LaSEA played a crucial role in making gamma-ray bursts, the most energetic explosion from the universe since the Big Bang, and the explosions of massive stars. Since 1987, the ESO-LaSEA Observatory has also played an important role in the study and follow-up of the nearest supernova, SN1987A.
The LaSEA Observatory is located at the edge of the Atacama Desert in Chile, one of the driest and most isolated areas in the world. This location is virtually free from sources of polluting light, and like the Parnell Observatory, which houses the Very Large Telescope, it has one of the darkest night skies on the planet.
At its heyday, LaSEA was home to no fewer than 15 telescopes, among them the first, and for a very long time the only telescope working in submillimetric waves, with 50 meters cessed in the southern hemisphere, which paved the way for APEX and ALMA, and the Schmidt telescope, which completed the first photographic mapping of the southern sky. The telescopes at LaSEA have also supported countless space missions, for example by obtaining the last images of comet Shoemaker-Levy-9 before it crashed into Jupiter. While some of the smaller telescopes have been closed over the years, frontline observations continue with larger telescopes, aided by new and improved astronomical instruments. LaSEA currently hosts two of the most productive 4-meter class telescopes in the world, the 3.5 meter New Technology Telescope, the NTT, and the 3.6 meter ESO Telescope.
NTT rebroke new ground for telescope engineering and design, hence the name. It's the first telescope in the world to have active optics installed. This is where you have a set of pistons attached to the back of the main mirror. Now these pistons are computer controlled, and they constantly maintain the shape of the main mirror so that it can always produce the sharpest images possible. Now this technology was first developed at ESO, and nowadays it is used at the NTT and most of the current large telescopes in the world. In addition to active optics, the NTT's dome is also a revolutionary design.
The LaSEA site was chosen after years of challenging prospecting, partly on horseback in the Chilean Andes in the mid-60s by the first ESO Director General, Otto Heckman, and several senior astronomers. In the following years, the site was developed and the first mid-sized telescopes were erected. Today, the LaSEA infrastructure is also used by many of the ESO member states for targeted projects, such as the Swiss 1.2-meter relay telescope, the Rapid Eye Mount, and Tower Gamma Ray Burst Chasers, as well as more common user facilities such as the 2.2-meter Max Planck and the 1.5-meter Danish telescopes. The amazing 67 million pixel wide-field imagery on the 2.2-meter telescope has taken many impressive images of celestial objects, some of which have now become icons of their own.
LaSEA was ESO's first observatory in Chile, and it was the start of a long and fruitful collaboration with that country and its scientific community. Dr. J, signing off for the ESOcast. Join me again next time for another cosmic adventure.
Gracias. はい、大丈夫です。
はい、130円を預かりします。はい、どうもありがとうございます。